looking at. Oh yeah, this afternoon heard a very unique radio broadcast that, as far as I know, there's nowhere else in the world that even comes close to it. And that's from WDEV in Waterbury. It's called Music to Go to the Dump Fire. And it's a tradition I guess you would say family radio, but family radio is not quite what I would call that station. I think I'd call community radio. You know, without the high drop stuff, in other words, it's not NPR or Lamar Public Radio. But anyway, I was reminiscing as I listened to that show earlier today. And the funny thing was, I was shortwave listening, and I heard the CIA station come up out of Nicaragua. It said it was a telegraph station. We suppose that as an old telegrapher, I could go to Nicaragua, and in my final waning years, get behind the coast team and get a job as a telegrapher. Oh, yeah. Yeah. All right. We'll have to look into that. BLT. Bacon, lettuce, and tomato. Is that right?
Yeah, right, Mark?
BLT is bacon, lettuce, and tomato, right? I mean, if you're not, you know, being sarcastic. Well, all these guys. Going nice. And we're going to take requests. If you got any, put them on the HL, send HL, whatever it is there. And I'll try to get to them. I've got any questions. We'll get to it. And we've been having some technical difficulties here with the radio frequency stuff. I thought I was going to have to go, really, 10 watts, but now until the cows come home. But I was able to fit my, my four-film amplifier, and then I found a two-film amplifier that works pretty good, too. So that's the story, and it's oldies night, and, it's Saturday, right? When you get to be my age, friend, you're lucky if you know what day of the week it is. I mean, seriously. And it's good. It's good that you don't know. I mean, the only way I knew that it was Sunday when I was a kid was Ma had the bath towels out, and we all had to get in the tub. No, not together. We all had to get in the tub and take a bath. Because, of course, Monday would be school again. And, the school, clean halls were out for school and that kind of thing. Now, that's a year that's gone by. Maybe if you never experienced that. But that's Green Mountain Living up in Vermont. Now, I suppose it's not unique to here, but I just thought I'd share that with you. And we got some time off from the sheep and goats tonight. Everybody's happy. The cats are here. They're all purring. And my gosh, we should not forget. So, it's Golden Oldie tonight, as they say, here on Goatherder Radio. So, if you can hear us, good. I'm glad. I think the radio conditions improved. As I say, I was messing around this afternoon, and I noticed everything was dead, you know, like Aurora. Everything was gone, and then suddenly, for some reason, it was like somebody pulled a switch, and the noise level came up, and, you know, everything was back to normal again. I honestly thought I had a dead radio, but it wasn't. It was just, you know, the way radio conditions are, you know, when the sun's up. Well, anyway, too much for that. So how's your life been treating you? We're going to go back and hear some more Golden Oldies here. I don't know what I should put on. The real oldies from the 1960s, or should I treat the 1970s as 1980s also? There's a lot of good news down in 1980s. Even now that's early 1990s, right? So What about, let's see, what can we go with here?
Well, we won't do a blown-in only. We'll do some balance cam.
And I wonder if any of you know what balance cam called itself. John Cougar Johnson. And he was one of those sweet-looking little boys. He didn't quite have the masculinity. You know, he had to ride a motorcycle and, you know, sort of be like Bob, you know, didn't have that big masculine look to him. But anyway, he's very rich today and all that stuff.